see anyone with the hello tree middle-aged woman in the second row. Hi. Oh. Sorry. 30-year-old ladies, 30-year-old. Hello, you beautiful young creatures. What brings you here tonight? Are you, how do you know Jackie?
We're celebrating someone's birthday, 18th birthday.
Wow, so they are young and blind, fantastic. You're so offended. I'm offended. I'm like 12 years old, you know. And whose birthday is it? Can we just ask? Hello, young one, what's your name?
Alicia,
how old are you? Show me in fingers how old you are today.
54.
54, huh? Yeah! That's right! 11 more years of CPF! Yeah! Yeah. Well, we should all sing her a happy birthday song, okay? On a count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Who's it for? Happy birthday to you. Round of applause. My God, you have lived a life and you're spending it here in a comedy club. Do you know who Jackie is as a friend? So you spend your birthday with a random 22-year-old. That's not creepy at all. Coming for Jackie. Okay, so you really are blind. Can't fucking read. But thank you anyway. And are you single? Are you attached?
No, I'm married.
You're married. Where's the hubby? Oh no, sorry. It's your birthday. You're gonna get fucked up tonight, aren't you? Oh my. No. Are we gonna get all fucked up, boys and girls? We have to take a biscuit. As you can see, it's a very millennial crowd here tonight. None of them have paid taxes in their life. None of them have ever had like a Nokia phone. You're all young except for Lupin over there. Sorry. Grandpa. So, what are you looking for? What do you want for your birthday this year? Apart from CPF, what do you want for your birthday this year? Okay, every time, what would you like for your birthday? We'll see if we can make it happen for you.
No, I'm just very happy celebrating my friends.
Aww, you're terrible friends. We could have gone around to Orchard Towers and we could have a good time. We're going to make sure you have a great time here. We will have a great birthday. I think I'm not going to take up too much time because I think everyone's finally settled in. We're going to start the show. So, ladies and gentlemen, are we ready to bring on your headliner for this evening? If we don't, make some fucking noise! We're starting to quiet. So, everyone, please, put your hands together. Start clapping. Start cheering, and welcome to the stage, Singapore's very own Mr. Jackie!
Hey, keep the applause going for your guys, MC, yes. Very nice, thank you so much for coming around, there's a lot of people here, very happy. I'm gonna start a show by saying that I'm a student, right? I go to a private university. Right, some of my schoolmates are here, and then they'll back me up when I say this. My school fees are really expensive. Woo! Right, my school fees, they add up to about $40,000. Okay, and $40,000 is clearly money I don't have. Okay, because this is what I do for a living. Right, but luckily my grandfather knew. He never told anyone this, but my grandfather knew. Right, like you could see in his eyes when he held me as a baby. My grandfather. Right, his eyes would say the same thing every time. His eyes would say, my grandson, my cute, chubby, stupid grandson. It's a look of love, okay? Right? So he saved up exactly $40,000 for me and my sister to go to school, right? So I talked to my dad, I was like, hey dad, if you wanna go to school, it's gonna cost you $40,000. And he was like, oh, you wanna go to school? School is good, go to school. I'm like, but dad, it's a lot of money, right? He's like, no. Your grandfather saved up, do you forget? Your grandfather has the money, right? I'm like, but isn't that money for me and my sister? And I'll never forget this night, right? My dad, he sat me down, he looked me in the eye, he reassured me, he said, Jackie, don't worry about your sister, Jackie. Your sister is smart. Jackie, your sister is a top student in an elite school in Singapore, and you are a comedian. Please go to school. So I'm in school now, and I don't want to brag, but like, I'm like a good student, okay? Like, I get great grades, okay? Right, like the other day, we had a presentation, right? And the teacher released the grades for a presentation on a piece of paper, right? And the paper had your name, some feedback, and your score out of 100, okay? So it's like, Jessica, nice speaking voice, speak louder, 75. Tommy, nice speaking voice, speak softer, 80. Jackie, good, 94. Great, I'm a great student. But I enjoy going to school because you meet a lot of people, because it's an international, private international school, you meet a lot of different people. Right, like in our school, we have a Cambodian pop star. Right? She flies home to Cambodia on the weekend, she sings some songs, she comes back for class. It's like, we have that, and there's also like gay people in school, which is great. You know, you don't get to meet gay people all the time in Singapore. But in school, you know, right? Like, it's very nice when you're having lunch and then some guy comes and be like, hey, Jackie, what are you eating? Laksa? Spicy. Right? Like, my favorite person in school, this girl, her name is Belle. She's my best friend in school, I think, right? Belle, she cuts my hair. I pay $40,000 for my school fee so I can get free haircut from Belle. Okay? And this is why I really like Belle as a person, because Belle's the kind of person that tells you when she's on her period. Okay? But she doesn't just say like, hey guys, I'm on my period, don't mess with me. This is what she says, right? She says, hey guys, my meow meow is bleeding. Meow meow is pussy. Yeah. Because you didn't react. It's not funny, I'm so sorry. Not. How long? We're 3 minutes in, we have one not funny, okay? Let's see how long we can go. Let's see. Right? But the thing about meeting people is that when they find out that I'm a comedian, they always say the same thing. They're like, oh, Jackie, you're a comedian. Tell me a joke. You're very funny. Tell me a joke. Right? And I never know what to say to that because it's hard to tell jokes in public. Right? But this is what I say now when people ask me to tell a joke. I figure it out. Right? I'll say, my style of comedy is for like a smarter audience. I'm not saying that you're stupid and you won't get the joke. I'm just saying that, you know, it's for a specific type of audience. And it's not like we cannot be friends if you don't like my comedy, you know, like it's a different thing. Like me and you, we can be friends even if you don't enjoy my comedy, you know. And then you'd be like, oh, so you tell me smart jokes, tell me, just tell me, why, I'm not scared, just tell me. I'm like, okay, sure, here's your joke. Instead of using the words male and female to describe the gender of a cat, we should use the words meow and female. And then they go, oh yeah, smart joke. I like this kind. Very nice. It's like, wow, from thinking man comedy. I like it. Last year, I was really honored that the school asked me to perform at a school dinner and dance. Right, I was so honored. Right, like, you know, the school really cares about the talent they have in school. Right, I know that when they introduced me on the stage as they started serving fish in the banquet. Right, like, it's like, if anyone can compete with fish, it's Jackie. I went on stage, it was fine. And then after the show, my director came up to me and he said, Jackie, just want to let you know, I'm really proud of you. Keep doing what you're doing. You know, this is great that you're pursuing your passion, and I see that you're having a lot of fun. Right, and I was like, oh, well, sir, now that I have you here, I just want to say that, you know, it's very tiring that I have to come to school and I gotta perform at night and I gotta do my assignments. Right, now that I have you here, maybe I can just ask you. I'm not asking for no assignments, sir. I'm asking for less assignments if you think it's possible. And then my director said, ho, you are a funny man. I paid $40,000 to that fucker. Before I went to uni, I was in poly, and before poly, I went to a boys' school. Anyone here from a boys' school? Make some noise. Yeah. Make some boys' school boys. Boys' school boys are the worst. I came from a boys' school, and okay, before I carry on, I'm just gonna say that every school is a good school. That's what my PM told me, and that is the truth. Okay, different schools are just good at different things, right? Like my school, the boys, we were amazing. and disrespecting our teachers. Right? Like in my first year when I went to school, we had a teacher named Mr. Pereira. Right? Now Pereira is a normal Eurasian name. Nothing weird or whatever about it. Right? But the kids, we will make fun of him, and this is how we make fun of him. Right? We walk past his class and we say, Mr. Pereira. It's not clever or creative or anything. We just say that because we were a boys' school boys. We retarded. We walk past his class. Every time we'd be like, Mr. Pereira. Ho, 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 ho. Right? And Mr. Pereira, to his credit, he will ignore us. He ignores us for 6 straight months. Right? And then one day this guy comes up to me and says, Jackie, it's not funny anymore. He never reacts. It's not funny. You know what? Today we should try something new. Today, we go past his class. We sing him happy birthday. Like, is it his birthday? No, that's why funny, ma. Okay, we try. Right, so we went past Mr. Pereira's class and then this guy shouted, hey, Mr. Pereira, today your birthday, is it? And then everybody went, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Right, and then he ignores us. Right, this carries on for 6 more months. Right, now, Mr. Pereira is also the teacher in charge of football. And I was in the football team. Right, and the one day that we won the Southzone Championships, right, one of the most beautiful days of my life, we were on the bus back to school and we were celebrating, we were singing, dancing in the bus, right, Mr. Pereira was sitting in the front of the bus marking his science papers. I was sitting beside Mr. Pereira because I'm just enjoying the atmosphere, right, we're singing, we're dancing, it was great, and then one guy from the back shouted, hey, Mr. Pereira, today you're both there, and then the whole bus went, happy birthday. And I turned to Mr. Pereira and I saw he was marking his paper and a single tear. I haven't figured out if he was crying because we finally cracked him or it was his birthday and nobody even remembered. Like, oh my god, these boys, they remember. They are good kids. They are good kids. Hey guys, I was going to say that I've been doing comedy for 5 years, right? So that makes me a professional. So I was at a dance the other day. I went to watch a modern dance performance. I don't know if you guys know what modern dance is, but it's really interesting because modern dance is like telling a story with your body, you know? And you really gotta pay attention because if you're not, then you get lost in the plot of the dance, you know? But lucky for me, there was a baby sitting in the front row. I mean, in front of me, right? You know how babies are like in a cinema? They just say whatever they see. Right, they'll be like, mommy, 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 look, it's a Batman. Batman is fighting with the bad person. Right? So it's very annoying in a cinema, but very helpful in a modern dance. Right, the whole dance, the baby is just going, mommy, 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 look. Look, they are holding hand and dancing together because they are one big happy family. Wow, thanks, baby. Mommy, 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 look! They are holding hand and they are like going like a wave because they are in the sea now and there are turbulent waves. Wow, the baby knows the word turbulent. There was one part of the dance that was really confusing, right? Like everyone was lying on the floor and just hitting the ground, just going. I was like, what the hell does that even mean? And the baby goes, mommy, 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 look! They are all lying on the floor and hitting the ground because they are angry. They are angry at Singapore's capitalist government. I'm like, wow. It's a fucking communist baby. Any virgins in tonight? Make some noise. Alright, we have a few virgins. Very nice. I just want to tell you guys that if you are a virgin, don't be ashamed if you're a virgin, okay? Because like myself, I only lost my virginity at the age of 24, right? And guys, I am 24. Every time I do that, people ask me, Jackie, how happened? How you lose your virginity? And the answer is the same. The answer is always the same, right? The answer is, I had sex. But I'm not gonna tell you what happened in the bedroom, okay? But this is what happened after we were done, right? After we were done, I was sending the girl off, right? Because that's what my friends tell me is the gentlemanly thing to do, right? They say, Jackie, after you're done having sex with a girl, send her off. right? So I put the girl in a cab, right? And I wanted a cigarette. I light up a cigarette, and my whole body was like completely relaxed, right? Like my legs went soft. It was as if the strength in my leg was cum, right? And when the cum came out, I had no more strength, right? And I was smoking a cigarette, and I was stumbling back to my block. And when I got back to my block, I tripped, and when I got up, there was an old man waiting for the lift. Right, he was just standing, just like, ugh, young people. I was like, oh my god, I don't know what I did to this guy, but he looks upset. Right, and the lift came, we went in, we're in the lift, and he just, like, he just made me feel uncomfortable. I was like, I have to say something to him. Right, so before I came, I went out of the lift, I was just like, hey uncle, I just had sex. Right, then I saw the uncle finally smile. Lift door slowly close. I haven't seen Uncle since. He's like the virginity fairy. Like when you lose a teeth, the tooth fairy shows up. And when you lose a virginity, and maybe one of you guys will meet him someday soon, hopefully. What's next? Hey, who's drinking tonight? Make some noise. Right, please keep buying more drinks, because that's how we get to keep this place, right? Like, I don't drink a lot myself, because I have a condition. I don't know if you guys know this. My condition is, it's called the Asian flush. Right? Like you right now. Right? Like, the Asian flush is when you have alcohol and your face turns red. Right? And that the phrase always confused me. I'm like, why do they call it a flush? Right? If anything, it's a blush. Right? When your face is red, it's a blush. Right? And I was like, why do they call it a flush? So I asked Sam this the other day. I was like, hey Sam, why do you think they call it a flush? And Sam was like, Jackie, your face looks like a toilet. It's a flush. So at the start of last year, I tried to up my alcohol tolerance. I bought myself a bottle of tequila, right? And I would have like 2 shots of tequila every night before I go to sleep. Right? My face would be very red, then I knock out. Right? But one night, I started too early, right? And my mom came home and she called me. She came home, she was like, Jackie, you stay home? Wait, Jackie, why your face so red? Are you drinking? I'm like, yeah, I had 1 shot of tequila. 1 shot of tequila, your face so red. Lousy drinker. That's my mom. Please keep drinking if you enjoy alcohol. What about any drug addicts in tonight? Make some noise. Oh, we have one? Okay, fantastic. Well, my dad's a policeman, so... drugs is a big problem, right? Like, drugs, like, everywhere in the world, there are drug abusers, right? But I think Singapore, we had a solution. We came out with a solution 3 years ago. Right? I don't know if you guys know this, but 3 years ago, Singapore appointed Jackie Chan as our anti-drug ambassador. Okay, and that's it, problem solved. Because it doesn't matter who you are, if you take drugs, Jackie Chan will kick your ass. Okay, but more than that, right? I grew up watching Jackie Chan movies. He's like a father I never had. And I just really don't want to disappoint Jackie Chan. Like, can you imagine if I was taking drugs and then Jackie Chan found out? I'd be like there, like, this is how people take drugs, right? Like, and Jackie Chan comes in and says, oh my god, Jackie, are you doing drugs? And I'd be like, oh my god, I'm so sorry, Jackie. Like that, now that joke is so funny because we have the same name. Right, but now that we have Jackie Chan on our side, I feel like we can use him for like more things, you know, like cigarette smoking. Who smokes cigarettes here? Okay, we have a few, right? And the cigarette packaging is like, we have those disgusting pictures, right? Like a dead baby. But like, who's gonna stop smoking because of those pictures? Right, like, give me a pack, here's a dead baby. Oh yeah, keep smoking. Fuck you, baby. Doesn't matter, right? But now that we have Jackie Chan, I think we should, instead of having those disgusting pictures, we should have pictures of Jackie Chan in a variety of disapproving poses. Every pack you get is Jackie Chan like, I will quit smoking immediately. You know, and then we can have like special holographic packets where you turn the pack, it's Jackie Chan shaking his head. Or like healthy living, right? Like right now, what does the government do to make us eat healthier? You get rewarded with a pyramid. The healthier food sign. Right? When you buy juice, you're like, oh yeah, I'm living a healthier life. Right? who the fuck cares about the pyramid, right? Like if Juice had a picture of Jackie Chan giving me a thumbs up, I'm dripping juice. I love Jackie Chan. You guys think Jackie Chan would like that joke?
Yes.
Yes. I think I'll send it to him later. I recently started dating. I have a girlfriend now. Right? I've only been dating for a month, so I haven't written any jokes about her. Right? But what I have is a lot of jokes about being single. So this the next 10 minutes, if you can just pretend I'm single, the joke will work better. I mean, I could have just told a joke without telling you that I got attached, but I'm attached and I want to tell people. So this next 10 minutes, just pretend I'm single and you have a better time. So I'm single, surprise! I've been single for so long, guys, fucking hell. I've been single for so long that my mom, she's given up hope. She just doesn't think she'll have a daughter-in-law anytime soon. Right, like the other day, I had a female friend come over to my place. We were hanging out, right, and she got thirsty. I gave her a glass of water. She left a lipstick stain on the cup. Didn't think too much about that, left it in the sink. And the next day, my mom, who knows I do some kind of comedy performance out there, she said, Jackie, Jackie, but when you say you do the comedy, right, is it like the Kumar comedy? is it you wear the dress and the make, is it like that? Is it like that? Like, no, mom, it's not like I'm a stand-up comedian, I'm not a drag queen, I stand on stage and I tell jokes. So, oh, you stand on, Kumar also stand on. But Jackie, I tell you, Kumar very funny, you know. I watched the YouTube, the Kumar, haha, very funny, I laugh. Right? You funny, man? You funny, man? I see you come home quiet, never say anything, eat your dinner. You go inside your room, I don't know what video you watch. You funny, man? What I'm saying is, my mom thinks I'm more likely to be like a lousy drag queen than to bring a girl home. She never... Right? But if your mom thinks you're more likely to be a drag queen, then bring a girl home and still calls you her son, she must love you. Right? And I love you too, ma. No, this is how I looked up as if my mom was there. My mom's at home. She's at home watching Kuma. Mama, I'm doing my 1 hour show. You funny, man? any couples in tonight make some noise? You guys dating, married? Dating? How long have you been dating? Oh, okay. Do you remember?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, sweet. What's your name?
Michael,
and you are?
Kay.
Okay, Kay, answer me this. Does Michael snore in his sleep?
Yes.
Okay, Michael, answer me this. Does Kay snore in her sleep? No? Correct answer. Very good. Now, I ask because I don't usually sleep with anyone. But like when I go on holiday with my family, my parents, we sleep in the same room, and my dad snores very loudly, right? And the problem with snoring is this, right? Like snoring is like a recurring sound, it's not continuous, right? Like snoring sounds like that, right, when you're sleeping. Taiwan, my dad, he snored so hard that he coughed. My dad went and I was lying down beside him like genuinely worried that he might die, and then immediately disappointed he didn't die. Every time I do that, he said, "Oh, Jackie, you don't like your father, is it? Your father paid $40,000 for your school. At night you go talk shit about your father, right?" I'm like, no, of course not. I love my dad, right? My dad, he's heard the joke. He likes the joke, he told me, right? And my dad's a big inspiration for me growing up doing comedy. So my dad's a funny guy, right? That's what my dad has to do for fun, okay? Right? Once, he ended work early, right? He came home about 4:30. No one was home. What does he do? He mopped the floor. He mops the whole house, right? The floor is wet, and then he leaves. Right? my mom comes home from work, see the floor wet. Don't know who mopped the floor. And she freaks out. She calls me, she's like, Jackie, you mopped the floor. No, mama, I never mopped the floor. Jackie, I just come home, I tell you, the floor someone mopped it. I don't know who mopped. Who mopped the floor? I don't know, mama, I don't know. Jackie, you think someone broke into our house? Mop the floor and then leave? No, mom, I don't think so. Jackie, come home, I'm very scared. I don't know. I'm on the way home. Faster. And then I put down the phone. And then my dad sent me a text. He's like, Jackie, I mopped the floor. Don't tell your mom. Winky face emoji. Like, kind of a shit prank is that? It's like Jackass, but for your father. Hey guys, I just want to let you know that I've been doing it for 5 years now. And that means that I am a professional. I stay in Yishun. Anyone here stay in Yishun? No? Okay. Just me, thank you. Lucky people. I actually just moved into Yishun. You might be thinking, Jackie, why the fuck would you move to Yishun? Right, and here's why. At the start of last year, my parents, they paid off the flat that they got when they first got married. So now they can sell that flat, use the cash, and buy a brand new flat to retire in. Right? So we were on the market looking for a flat, and then the Straits Times reported that our new president, Madam Halimah Yacob, she will stay in Yishun despite her new status as president. Because she grew up in Yishun, she loves Yishun, she's going to stay in Yishun. Right? So my dad was like, if Yishun is good enough for my president, it's good enough for me. So we bought a house, we moved into Yishun. 2 weeks later, the Straits Times reports that Yishun is not safe enough for the president. The president will be moving into the Istana, and I'm still in Yishun. My friend who works in medicine told me this, right? She said, Jackie, you know that the moment your address on the back of your IC changed to Yishun, you are 30% more likely to die. My friend who works in medicine is a receptionist at a vet clinic. So you can trust a professional opinion. You know? And my address is not Yishun, it's Canberra. Or my mom say Canberra. It's Canberra, right? It's an area between Yishun and Sembawang, right? And I don't know if like the government is trying to like change people's perspective on Yishun or like attract new young couples to Yishun, but they give the estates like westernized names, right? They call it like North Brooks at Canberra, or Eastling One at Canberra, or Westbrook at Canberra, you know, things like that. So now when I meet someone, they ask me, Jackie, where you stay? I say, oh, I stay in North Brooks at Canberra, you know, beside the Sheng Siong supermarket. Yishun, right? Have you guys been to Yishun recently? Okay, good, don't come. There's a lot of dead cats. The moment you walk out of MRT, it's like, oh, yo, dead cat. Hey, got one cow over there. What the fuck? What's next? I just want to tell you a little story about myself. When I was a little kid, right, I was a very stupid kid. Okay, I'm sure you can tell. Right, but I would look at my mom as a kid, I would say things like, Mommy, when I grow up, I want to become a cat. And my mom would look at me and say, oh, Jackie, you want to be a cat? Very good. Do it. Jackie, I am your mother and I have given you the gift of life. Go live your life. Right, she was drunk, my mom. And I was four. Right, but that's like an encouraging mother, right? Like that's what you want to hear as a kid. Your mom telling you you can be anything you want, right? I'm 25 this year. I don't think that dream is coming true anytime soon. I'm not gonna become a cat anytime soon. But the great thing about doing stand-up is this: I get to tell you guys jokes in character. Okay, so here is a joke I wrote as a cat. Okay, would you guys like to hear that? Yeah. You don't have a choice. You don't have a choice. I'm gonna do the joke. Meow, meow. Oh, sorry, I forget. It's a knock-knock joke. It's a call and respond. Okay, so Try again, okay, everyone? Everyone, huh? Meow, meow. Who? Why are you speaking English to a cat? How often do you go up to a cat and like, hey, what are you doing? I'm going home. No, never happens. You see a cat, you speak in cat, okay? And right now, I am in character as a cat. Okay, let's try that again. Meow, meow. Meow, meow, meow. Meow, meow. Meow, meow. You get it?
No.
No? This would be like so much funnier if like all of you were cats. Like, I did this joke at a cat cafe behind last week. Because the Mary Lion was like, hey, Jackie, don't let him come through. So I performed there. And the cats love it. The cats were like, meow, 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 meow. You should have been there. You know, I did this joke at the Esplanade one time. Same response. Same. Anyone here a big fan of pornography? Make some noise. Okay? About one-fifth of this room is honest. The rest of you are lying. Right, I watch a lot of porn. You know, I feel like I've been watching too much porn, but this is what happened to me like last week, right? Like, okay, I was watching porn, right? I'm lying on my bed, right? And my laptop is here, you know? And there's like a blanket, because you know, the laptop gets hot. So I'm watching porn, right? I'm jacking off, right? And then when I came straight up. And then it landed on the space bar. And the video paused. It felt like my penis telling me, okay, enough! No more! I watched so much porn that last year for my birthday, my friends, they put together money to get me a Pornhub Premium account. Is anyone here on Pornhub Premium? No, of course not. You have lives. Now, you might be thinking, is Pornhub Premium worth it, Jackie? Right? And I made a list, a pros and cons list for you guys, for you to assess your own by yourself, right? So, first off, the cons. No cons. The pros, no cons. No advertisement, okay? And premium videos, okay? Premium, these are videos you can only watch if you have a Pornhub Premium account. So needless to say, that's where I dive hit in when I got an account. The first video I saw on Pornhub Premium is called Big Strong White Man Fuck Skinny Chinese Girl. Right? Which is, you know, unfortunately a very common porn title. 4 out of 10 videos are called Big Strong White Man Fuck Skinny Chinese Girl. Right? But this is the plot of the video, okay? The plot of the video is this: Big Strong White Man, as advertised, is walking. Right, he's walking into a dark alley, right? Because you know, that's where you find the skinny Chinese girls. The dark alley. Right, he walks in and he sees the girl and then he's like, hey, what's up, baby? Right, and then he cuts to the girl replying, but when the girl opened her mouth, it wasn't her voice. It was dubbed over by another white guy using his stereotypical Asian accent. Right, so he was like, what you doing, baby? Hey, what you doing in my alley? I was watching that, I was like, what the fuck? Watch us porn like that. And then I came. And then the video paused. Check it out, Pornhub Premium. Oh my god, it's only been 30 minutes. 30 minutes more, guys. Have you been enjoying yourself?
Yeah!
Alright! Alright, hey. Hey, we have some special guests in the house. Right, we have Shark. Shark, if you don't know, he is releasing his new album soon. Right, he sang at National Day last year. One of my favorite friends ever. Shark, you mind coming up on stage? Help me out for a fat man here, if you don't mind.
Go,
Shark. Come, Shark, hurry up. Hey guys, this is a segment of the show I call Alternative Meanings to Words That Already Have Meanings. Several meanings. Okay, so what's gonna happen is this, right? We know the English language, we know words have meanings. I've come up with a few more, okay? So Shark and I, we will share these meanings, and then we will use scene work to explain to you how to use these new meanings. Sounds cool? Okay? Thanks for coming, by the way, Shah. Yeah, I mean, you also pay the same amount as them, lah, right? But you have to work. So, you know, good for you guys. Okay, so yeah, first word. Okay, first word. Training. Right, what does training mean? The action of teaching a person or animal of, you know, training. Okay, alternative meaning to the word training is taking the train. Sharply.
Hey, how are you going home after the show?
Training, taking a train. Training.
next word.
kidding, right? Kidding, you know, kidding, like to mock playfully. Kidding, right? Right. Alternative meaning to the word kidding. Making a kid. Man, please don't steal my punchline.
Hey, how are things going with your wife?
Oh, great, we were just kidding. next word. Okay, now you do the next one for that. Hazmat, you know hazmat? Hazmat, short for hazardous material, right? Right, but the alternative meaning to hazmat is hazardous mud. Mud, Malay male.
Hey, what do you think of that guy, Ahmad?
I think you stay away, he's a hazmat.
Last word,
I have one more word before Shah can go pack. Assurance, right? Assurance, a positive declaration. My dad assured me, right? Assurance. Alternative meaning to the word assurance? Insurance for your ass.
Wow, check out that girl's butt.
Yeah, man, she better get some assurance on her shit. Round of applause for Shah, everyone. Thank you. Yeah, I don't know if you guys noticed, but I recently went to Ho Chi Minh and I participated in the Ho Chi Minh Amateur Vietnam Amateur Comedy Competition. I represented Singapore and I won. Now, winning is not a big deal, but I won. I want to tell you guys. Right, but like the great thing about doing comedy is I get to travel a lot and I get to like meet a lot of different people and learn different things. Right, like in Vietnam, you know that phrase. Live every day like it's your last day. Yes. That's how the people in Vietnam live. Because the traffic is fucking insane. You leave your hotel, you can die anytime. This is how the traffic in Vietnam works, right? Like I was on a bike, okay? And every junction, a bike will come too close. Right? You just be like, oh, this guy is too close. And then went to the next. Oh, this guy is too close. Oh, this. After a while, I realized, no, he is not too close. He is just nice. Everyone on the roads in Vietnam are at the exact right position for nothing to happen. That is how the traffic works, right? I'll work on that joke, but yeah. Just came back from Vietnam, but yeah. But we get to travel to many places, right? Like Singaporean comedians here, most of the time we go up to Malaysia. And Malaysia is a dangerous place. Remember the first time I went to Malaysia, people were like, hey Jackie, you go to Malaysia, be careful. Malaysia very dangerous, people rob you, keep your things. Careful, Malaysia very dangerous. People take a rob you. And then I went to Malaysia, and I think they're exaggerating, because I was there for a week, right? And I only got robbed like what, 2 times? The way they say it is like, you get robbed every minute of every day. No, it's not as bad as you think. Okay, and the robbers, they took my ringgit. So we also go to the Philippines sometimes, and the Philippines is great. People in the Philippines, amazing people, very, very kind, right? Even the homeless people were kind, right? On my last day in the Philippines, this homeless boy came up to me, he put out his hand, and I was like, you know what? I've been here a whole week. The people here have been nothing but nice to me. I should give my remaining pesos to him. So I gave it to him, and then the kid said, "Tomo arigato!" And I was like, wow, this kid is so polite. But kind of racist, I don't know. I don't know if homeless people are allowed to be racist. Get a house first, then you can be racist. Is anyone of you homeless? Who the fuck's offended here? Calm down. I got to visit Japan last year, so Japan is great. Right, people in Japan are nice also, right? Super nice. After one gig in Japan, this guy came up to me. He's like, "Hey man, thank you so much for coming down here to perform for us. You've been great, blah, 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 blah." I was like, "Oh man, thank you so much." He's like, "No man, thank you, man. You came down all the way to perform for us and you were great, you're so funny. I really like your set. Thank you. "No man, thank you, you're so nice." It's 5 minutes, I'll never get back ever again. What's after Korea? Okay. And then I went. I was in Korea for 6 weeks. Any Korean people here? No. Good. I fucking hate Korean. Are you Korean?
No.
Oh yeah. Fuck Korea. Right. Like, I don't know if you guys been to Korea, but like it felt to me like when I was there that Korean people, they are kind of racist, right? Like they don't like you if you can't speak Korean, right? Like me and my friends, we were trying to enter a club. Right, we got to the front of the line and then we showed the bouncer our passport and then he just waved us off. And we were like, "What?" Right, we were confused, we were just smoking a cigarette by the side and then another bouncer comes along and we were like, "Excuse me, sir, what's wrong? Like, why can't we enter the club?" And the guy was like, "Boy, go, you are now in Korea. You better learn to speak Korean." He walked away. I was like, wow, this guy hates people who speak English. But he speaks English quite well. Did he learn English just to tell people he hates? It's very Korean. It's a very Korean thing to do. It's like, imagine if you hate a dance, like you hate the robot, right? Then you learn the robot to make, like, you're the best robot dancer in the world. You go to the club, you're like, "Hey, you look, this sucks." That's what the guy was doing. Fucking hate Korea. You know, I was in Korea for 6 weeks. It's the longest I've ever been, like, away from home. And I really started to miss Singapore, right? How many Singaporeans here make some noise? And like growing up, I was never really like proud to be a Singaporean until I went to Korea for 6 weeks and I saw how terrible the people there are, right? But I really started to miss Singapore and when I travel, what I can do is I can talk about Singaporeans to the people there, right? Do we have any foreigners in tonight?
Yeah.
Right. Where are you from, sir?
UK.
UK. How long have you been in Singapore?
A year and a half.
A year and a half. Yeah. You like Singaporean people?
Sorry.
You like Singaporean people?
Yeah.
Correct answer. Now when I travel and I like to tell people that Singaporean people, we are the most passive aggressive people in the world. Okay. Right. And give me an example. Right. About 2 years ago, 3 years ago. Right, a few years ago, one of our member of parliament, right, he was caught having an affair with his subordinate, right? And the only reason the media found out about the affair is because the subordinate's husband found out about the affair and then he complained. Anywhere else in the world, right, like in the UK, if your wife was sucking someone else's dick, you go out there, you chop the dick off, right? Not in Singapore. Right, in Singapore, if you find out your wife is sucking someone's dick, you sit down and write a strongly worded email. Imagine being that guy, he comes home from work. He's like, "Oh man, I'm gonna meet my wife, my beautiful wife." He opens the door, sees an MP fucking his wife. Who's the MP? Who's the MP? And the guy's like, "Oh my god, you fucking bitch, you cheating on me? You watch out!" He makes his way to the living room. He sits down at the family desktop computer they share. Then he stretch. www.gmail.com. "To whom it may concern, it has recently come to my attention that that the MP is fucking my wife. This greatly upsets me. Please do something about it. Yours sincerely, John. Right. And Singapore's an efficient country. Right? He gets a reply immediately. He sends the email, he gets a reply in his inbox immediately. The reply says, "Dear John, thank you so much for your email. Your feedback means a lot to us. I'll get back to you in 3 to 4 working days." Singapore doesn't have a lot of politics. I mean, like, we have politics, but like not many people talk about politics because like nothing interesting ever happens, right? Do you guys know who is Mr. Chiam See Tong? Mr. Chiam See Tong. Mr. Chiam See Tong, for those who don't know, he is Singapore's oldest opposition MP. Right? He was the first ever opposition MP. He was in charge of Potong Pasir, and he's old now. He's like 95. He's in a wheelchair, right? And, but I love him because he's from the opposition. He's fighting for the people, you know. And that's why I was so honored last year when I got invited to perform at the Chiam See Tong Sports Foundation dinner. Right? Me and Sam, we both went for the dinner, right? And then we sat at a table beside the stage. Right? And behind our table was a door. Okay, two doors, two banquet staff on standby. Right? And then before the dinner started, the host goes, "Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our guest of honor, Mr. Chiam See Tong." And then the theme song from Rocky started playing. Then the fucking smoke machine went. And the two guys on standby, they open the door and a big cloud of smoke comes up. Right? The music still going. And the cloud of smoke clears. Who is there? Mr. Chiam See Tong. He's sitting on his wheelchair. Okay? And then his wheelchair started to move. But he's not rolling his wheelchair. He's not a pedian like us, right? His wheelchair comes up. The smoke clears some more. Who is behind pushing Mr. Chiam? His Filipino helper. Then Mr. Chiam raised up his hand as if he was gonna wave to us. He didn't. He left his hand there. His helper waved him. And they carried on to their seat. And then he sat down. And then I looked at Sam. And then Sam looked at me and said, "Jackie, they haven't paid us, I don't laugh." But it paid me, so I feel like I can tell you this. What is next? How long? Oh my god, 15 minutes left? Wow! Alright, I was gonna say, other than Sharp, do you have any other musicians in? We have a few musicians in, right? Yeah, Yuresh is here, wow. A lot of fantastic. Like I have all these musician friends and I get very jealous of them. You know why? Right? Like, because music has an active audience. Right? Like they're dancing or moshing or grinding or whatever. Comedy is different. Right? Comedy audience is very passive. Right? Example, you guys. Right? Like, what's your job tonight? Your job is basically sit down, laugh at the things I say to make sure I don't cry to sleep tonight. And you know what? You guys have been doing a great job. Round of applause for yourself. Right? I was at a concert one time. Right, was dancing with my friends, right? That's how I dance. And then I saw this girl crowd surf from the left all the way to the right. And I was like, whoa, rock and roll. Right? And kept dancing. And then the next song started. I saw the girl crowd surf back from the right all the way to the left. But this time with like one less shoe. I see 1 foot. Rock and roll, right? I kept dancing. Right? And then at the end of the concert, she came up. She was walking around with one shoe. She was like, "Excuse me, sorry. I lost my shoe. I see my shoe." I'm like, "I'm sorry, I never see your shoes." "Oh, it's okay." And then I went home and then I saw that she tweeted. Right? She was like, "Hey guys, I recently lost my shoe at a concert. If you've seen it, please let me know. It means a lot to me. My grandfather gave me those shoes. Hashtag lost shoe." I don't know where her shoe was, but I wanted to help. So I retweeted the tweet, right? And I was on Twitter for a couple more hours. And then 6 hours later, I was surprised to see that hashtag lost shoe became a trending topic in Singapore. Right? And he had 6,000 retweets and one guy replied. Right? The guy said, "Hey, I have your shoe. If you like it back, please let me buy you dinner." Right? Which, if you ask me, is either the best pickup line ever or the worst pickup line ever, depending on the guy's face. Right? It was a good looking guy like you, sir. Right? If you found a shoe, I'll be. It's not a very good looking front row, I don't know what to say. Right? A good looking guy like you, Tanya, that found a shoe, she had gotten a shoe bag, you had dinner, happy for everyone. Right? If I had found a shoe, I would have a shoe. Anyone here been waxing before? Make some noise. Waxing? No? Just a bunch of hairy motherfuckers in here? Sure. I went waxing a while back, right? Like, this is what happened, right? Like, I don't usually pay for waxing. But what happened is last year, right? My friend, he usually gets a yearly package, 6 sessions a year, right? But in December, he was like, "Hey Jackie, my hair didn't grow as fast this year. I got 1 extra session, you wanna come?" So I went, right? And people always, "Where are you going, huh? Oh, you need to pee, yeah? Go. We wait for you to pee, yeah? 10 more minutes, cannot, 10 more, no. Go. Go. You go already, right? They think you must come back, sir. Right, okay, but waxing. Right, people always say, like, isn't waxing painful? Right, and yeah, it's kind of painful, but it's like, it's bearable pain that you get used to it after a while. Right, what it is a lot, like, it's very awkward. Right, more than painful, it's very awkward. Like, imagine this, right? 24, 25 year old boy, lying on a bed, bottomless, no pants. Right, lady from the Philippines. Right, she drops everything in the Philippines. She says, "I'm gonna go to Singapore to make money." She abandoned her family, she flies to Singapore to wax my balls. Okay, it's very awkward. Right, she doesn't seem to think so though. She seems to think like it can be more awkward. Right, because she insists on having small talk while waxing my balls. She'll be like, "Where you stay? What you do?" Right? And then she'll pour the wax as I'm answering her questions. "Where you stay?" "I stay ish." Right, it's not the worst, but the worst part is this, right? What I did was a boyzillion wax, right? Which is like a bikini wax, so they handle the bikini area. So once she's done with the front, she's moving on to the back, okay? And guys, this is how your ass works, okay? Your ass is basically 2 cheeks stuck together, okay? And the hair is not on the outside where it's easy to remove, no. It's on the inside, right? And you cannot just put wax in between like that, you know? Because then your cheeks get stuck and that is a different joke altogether. So what you have to do is you have to hold, someone has to hold the butt open while someone else waxes it, right? There's only 2 of us in the room. And she's trained to wax. So now I'm lying on my face. I'm presenting myself. She's waxing. And still she wants to know like my hopes and dreams. What you want to be when you grow up. And speaking of ass, like, I never understood why we have hairs back there, you know what I mean? Like evolutionary wise, like we learn why we have. What's that? Someone went, Are you okay, man? Okay, you have your white man, so no problem. Okay, carry on. So why do we have hair there? Like we learn, right? Like we have hair in your ears because it traps dirt, right? Hair in your nose to trap dirt, right? But your ass, that's the last place you want to trap anything. That's the place you want it to go clean, you know what I mean? Right, so I was curious, I asked my mom, right? I was like, "Hey mom, why are there hair there?" Right. And my mom said confidently, said, "Jackie, every strand of hair on your backside represent every lie you ever told me." Oops. Right, you know what that means, right? That means that Jesus Christ had a very clean ass. Because he never lies. all Christians here? No? Hey, Sam, what's up? Oh, okay. I'm at 51 minutes. I've underprepared material. I have one closing joke, but that's not going to take that long. Any requests? Any questions? No? What's that? Yeah, why? Why?
tell a joke about her, man.
Oh, tell a joke about her. Don't know. No, we started dating recently, right? And like no one in the house knows how to talk about relationships, right? Because like we haven't been in a relationship, no one in the house has been in a relationship in a long time. Like, my sister is single, I've been single, my parents' relationship, dead. So we don't know how to, right? Like, my mom was saying weird things. Like after she comes over, then she goes home, then the next day, then my mom be like, hey Jackie, when y'all sleep in your room, your bed got space, ah? I'm like, yeah, like, where else you want me to sleep? Like, you only bought me one bed, mom. Like, use your sister's bed, lah. Right, and then I suggested it to her. I was like, hey, my mom thinks we should go to my sister's room. And then she was like, gross, no. And I'm like, yeah, gross. But my sister's away for 6 months, so anytime, you just let me know. I really don't know if I should talk about her that much, because, you know, it's only been a month and I'm going to jinx it. We're at a comedy show, why am I telling you this? Okay, I should just do my last bit, right? So when I was in Korea, I genuinely missed home. Like, I never felt that homesick before in my life, right? I don't even usually drink, but on the last day of our trip in Korea, we drank a lot, because I was so sad I was missing home. And then we were really drunk in the morning, and then my friend said, hey Jackie, you know what? So what should you do? We should go to McDonald's and have breakfast. Because McDonald's breakfast tastes the same everywhere. You get the hot cakes, you get the McMuffin, you feel just like home. That's a great idea, right? We were drunk. We made our way to McDonald's, 1 km away, we walked all the way there. And I was in McDonald's, and I looked at the menu, and I saw the hot cakes, and I saw the McMuffin, and I saw the hash browns, and I saw that they got no ice Milo. Right then, a tear rolled down my eye. It's the kind of things you take for granted, you know? We so pampered at home, you know? Like you know, in the National Parade, people always cry when they play home, right? Like, if you don't cry when they play home, they take your IC back, alright? So, and people always say like, oh, I'm so patriotic, I cry when they play home. And everyone cries, right? Like, how patriotic is Jackie? I'm so patriotic, I cry when I see no ice Milo. Thank you so much.
Person, and I thought, my god, this guy is shit. But you got so much better, and I'm so proud you get to come out here and do your first hour. This is your chance to do your plug. So go ahead, plug all your shit.
Hey, I have free stickers to give away, so come to me and get your free stickers. And follow me on Facebook, Jackie and Comedy. It's all on the sticker. So take the sticker and then.
I don't want to follow you. What the spelling for Jackachu is?
Jackachu on Instagram is JAKACHUUU.
Views.
You cannot remember? Come take a sticker. Right? Do you think you can take a photo?
A bit hard. You can do like the.
Yeah, like maybe like.
So we're gonna take a video. We're gonna like, hey, we're gonna pan on you and everyone.
Right.
Yeah, we had a good time. Pretend. you do it.
Hey guys, I just did my first hour. The audience is here. Show them the audience.
We'll start again. Look happy.
Okay.
And then we all enjoy ourselves, guys. And then you're like, yeah, it's good.
Hey, you watching this video? I just did my first hour. Look at how excited the audience is. Thank you so much.
But